likes it. Don't you, Bryant? I reckon that pacemaker of yours must be jigging around like a puppet, and I'm pulling the strings. Now, who's top dog?
Don't, or you'll kill her!
Who's top dog, Bunny Bryant?
You are! Will you let it go?
Members of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
We have. We find the defendant guilty as charged.
And is this the verdict of you all?
It is.
You have performed your duties in a true and proper fashion.
Nice enough to get you out of here.
Annie Jane?
Oh, shame. Boy, you gave me a fright. What are you doing here?
Well, I didn't know whether you'd want me here or not. But you do, don't you?
Of course I do. But listen...
I can stay with you, can't I?
Now, Shane, wait a minute. You've got a home now. What about your new parents?
They're not my parents. They hate me.
Shane.
That's why I ran away. And I'm never going back there again. Never.
I think you'd better sit down, Bobby. I've got something to tell you, and it may come as quite a shock. Now, I'm sure you've got nothing to worry about.
But what's happened?
Well, first of all, I got this report on you from Mr. MacDonald.
But Mrs. Reynolds, I...
Oh, it's nothing like that. In fact, he's delighted with the way you're settling in. Your willingness, your attitude, in fact, everything about your behaviour, he's very happy with.
Well, then why can't I go back?
Just a minute, Bobby. Excuse me. Yes? Oh, good. They're here. Well, would you send them straight through? They're on their way. No, that's all right. Thank you.
Reynolds, why can't I go back to work tomorrow?
Well, something's come up, and it means you're going to have to attend a hearing in the morning.
What sort of hearing?
A special parole hearing.
Parole hearing?
Mr. Jenkins.
Come in.
Hello, Mrs. Reynolds.
Dan! Oh, Jesus, it's great. G'day, Edie.
Hello, dear. Surprised you, did we?
Oh, I reckon. Mrs. Reynolds, how come they're here?
Well, perhaps you'd better tell us, Dan.
I'd be delighted to. Well, you see, it's this way, Bobby. Edie and I have applied for you to be released to us on licence.
If you still want to, that is.
For want to? Oh, would I what? Oh, is this what the meeting's about tomorrow?
Yes, and if it's successful, you'll be able to live with Stan and Edie and continue your apprenticeship from outside.
Oh, you rotten buggers! Oh, jeez, now look what you made me do.
Nice?
Great. Don't get anything like that over there. Can I have some more?
Look, how about we talk about why you ran away first, Now, there must have been a reason.
Because I want to be with you.
Yes, I know, mate, but that's not possible. I'm going to have to take you back.
No, you can't. You wouldn't. Anyway, there'd be no point. They don't want me.
Now, what makes you say that?
It's true. They don't even like me. They just want someone to pick on all the time.
Oh, I find that a bit hard to believe, Shane.
I wouldn't lie to you. Honest. They hate me.
All right. What makes you think they're picking on you?
Well, for instance, the other night I had to go to bed without any tea. Just because I had a little smudge on my homework. And I was starving too.
Right. What else?
Well, Mr. Taylor said if he caught me watching TV again in the mornings... he'd belt me.
Oh, come on, I find that a bit hard to believe.
It's true. He meant it. And that dumb kid Tracy, I hate her.
Why?
Because she's always doing rotten things so I get the blame. And she does it on purpose. You won't send me back, will you?
What say we have a bite to eat and then we can talk some more?
Good thinking, Auntie Jane.
It's not to scale, is it?
No, I thought I'd do that later.
Good. What about the ears, though? Where do you think they should go?
How about on the head?
Oh. Top of the class, too.
Look, why don't I go and get the original drawing? You think that might help?
Good
idea. Yeah, it might give me a better idea where we're heading.
And we can throw the idea around a bit more, don't you?
Oh, Mrs. Barry, where's Bobby?
Well, she's still with Mrs. Reynolds.
Is she in trouble?
Can't help you. Sorry.
Look, where's Delaney?
I think she's still in the library, Mrs. Barry.
Right.
Hey, do you mind if I go to my cell? I forgot something.
Sure, you can keep me coming to the gates.
How's your daughter getting on those
days? We've got half an hour. Let's go and collect.
What about Barry?
It's okay. They're splitting up the gates. Little birdie told me that Mitchell's in the pound.
Oh, yeah? Rack off.
Just wanted to stop you worrying.
Oh, God, that. What a wimp.
Why? Just because she did something nice?
No, because she's got no guts. Reminds me of someone else I know.
Who?
Me? Yeah. Suppose it's not your fault, but your whole family are a pack of wimps.
At least my mum wasn't a child basher.
You stupid bitch! You wouldn't understand cutthroat! I'm sick and tired of you and shut up! Don't you ever down my mother again, Warren! Okay, so she beat up on me a couple of times, but only because I deserved it.
Hey, settle down. Marlene didn't mean anything.
At least my mum made me tough enough to stand on my own 2 feet. But look at you, you fat slug.
Guess what, everyone? Where's Jude? I might be getting out, Rabbit.
That's
fantastic.
Great news, Bobbie.
Great.
Congratulations.
I hasn't got any bloody ears. What do you want?
Not very friendly. Is she frank?
Reckon I should give her a bit of slap and tickle? Bring her around?
Not pretty enough. And besides, she's still missing her girlfriend, aren't you, Bryant?
Get out.
Sure.
As soon as you cough up your protection money.
You've got to be kidding. You're not getting a cent from me.
Sorry. I'm a bit hard of hearing. Say it again.
I said you're wasting your breath.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. I don't think she likes me, Lou.
Yeah, we're going to have to teach you some manners, Bryant.
Easier to pay up, love.
She's going to pay up anyway. We're going to have you buy up.
I mean,
you wouldn't want to be in debt to us, now would you?
She is.
Sorry, I really needed that.
Well, it's all over now. Wright got 8 years. That'll be the last you ever see of him.
Mm. Except when I wake up terrified from some nightmare.
Meg, it's all behind you. It's over.
Is it?
Of course it is. It'll need some adjustment, of course. You'll have to work at that. But I will be around.
Thanks. But I don't think they'll let you hold my hand on the operating table.
If you are so determined to make this a miserable night, I'll have to tell you some of my jokes. I'm the only one who ever laughs at them anyway. Look, have another drink, then you'll start feeling human.
Thanks, Chris.
Are you sure you're all right, Jude?
Yeah, I'm fine, love. I'm sorry I'm putting a damper on your party mood. I'm really glad for you, Bobbie.
That's okay. At least I get away from creeps like him.
Yeah, yeah, rotten buggers. Right. Don't worry, Myra will be back soon. She'll take care of them.
Yeah, why can't Matt and Geoff help us out?
No.
Why do you have to ask anyone for help? Why can't you fight your own battles?
Because Myra is the top dog. Now, we don't do anything without her okaying
it. Yeah, that includes selling dope. Have a guess what they're doing right now.
I reckon you're just complaining because they're making a few bucks.
That's not true.
Pathetic like hell. At least Lou isn't sitting on a bum waiting for the end of the earth to
come. Yeah, well, neither are we.
Oh, yeah? You sit around grizzling about everything under the sun, hoping Myra's going to fix up your problems for you. Well, I fight my own battles always.
Maxie,
for you.
That is just simply not true. You have to have a system here, a set of rules. You can't survive if you don't.
Oh, yeah? Well, look where it's got you. A big, fat nowhere.
Rotten bitch, look at her sucking up to those creeps.
Yeah, and one guess why.
Jude, you have to understand, Lex. She doesn't see anything.
Don't make excuses for her, Bobbie.
I'm not. I just want you to understand that she doesn't see anything wrong with drugs. She's grown up with them, same as me.
I won't accept this, Bobbie. You know how Myra and I feel about drugs. But you can't say to me she grew up with them. You only have to read the newspapers every day to see how it's mucked up people's lives. You can't justify drugs, Bobbie, so don't even try. Boy, have you and Lexie got a lot to learn.
Mr. Taylor? Joan Ferguson. I wanted to tell you that Shane is with me. He's all right, but I think he should stay the night.
Are you the auntie Joanie always talks about?
Yes, that's right.
Thank you. heavens, we wonder where he got to. I was about to call the police.
Oh, there's no need for that now.
Listen, I'll pick him up. It's no problem.
I'd prefer you didn't.
I beg your pardon.
Look, he's asleep, Mr. Taylor. He's had a very big day.
He's not the only one.
Mr. Taylor, I think I should come and have a chat with you and your wife about Shane.
Oh?
Well, it's just that there are a few things I'd like to get straight about his future with you.
Mrs. Ferguson, was it?
Miss.
Right, well, Miss Ferguson, I appreciate your interest, but Shane's future really is none of your business.
Mr. Taylor, I looked after that boy for quite some time, and I feel I have every right to talk to you about him.
I take your point. It's just that we've been worried sick.
Yes. Look, what say I take him to school in the morning and then come over to you?
Okay. I'll see you about 9:30.
Yes. Yes, thank you, Mr. Taylor. Good night.
Got something for you, kiddos.
Oh, yeah? What is it?
Little going away, Prizzy. Is that what I think it is?
Sure is.
Ah. One for you too, Grizzle Guts.
What is it?
Acid.
No, thanks. I'm allergic to all that stuff.
That'd be right.
It's true. I am.
Oh, sure.
She is. I got tricked into taking some coke a while ago. It nearly killed me.
A $2 tab wouldn't even give you a high. But why waste it, I say? Here, Bob's something to remember me by. Double dose of good luck for tomorrow.
Oh, suppose I can't be sure that they're letting me out tomorrow, can I?
Yes, you can, so you better give that stuff a big miss. You'd be in real trouble if the screws found out.
Oh, God, how the hell did I end up in a cell with a wowser? Come on, Bobs, the bloody screws aren't going to notice anything with the lights out.
Oh, what the hell?
Hey, Rabbit, sure didn't expect to be getting out before you. How long do you reckon you've got to go?
I don't know. Too bloody long.
Well, I'm going to be out in a few weeks. I'm going to prove that bloke's a liar when we get into court. Then look out, St Kilda. Here I come.
Wonder what it's going to be like, you know, with the family and everything. Never had a real family before.
Oh, who needs it anyway?
I don't know. I might like it.
Hey, boss, when I get out, how about we go out in the town together? Just you.
Oh, yeah, that'd be ace, Lex.
We'll go and swoop down on Carlo.
Oh, you mean he'll swoop down on you, the dirty bugger?
I thought you fancied him.
Get out, you can plait the ears on his back.
And his nose.
And his ears.
G'day, fella. What's the matter? Cat got your tongue? Hey, yeah. Want some coke? Adds life. Makes you feel real friendly.
You know what you can do with that.
Hey, how come you don't mind all this dope floating around? You're dead set against it at Woodridge.
Still am. Do you mind?
Don't sound like it here. Maybe you're finally seeing the light.
It's none of my business here. Myra Desmond says what goes. I'm not getting involved in anything unless I get asked.
Yeah, and Desmond ain't here. That means Lou and I run things. Cozy, all right?
Anyway, you've already hung yourself.
Eh? That bit of fun I had with Pixie. Didn't mean to go that far, you know?
Well, don't you worry. When the time is right.
Well, you better hurry. Because your date are numbered. Judging by that little gas and caper. You don't think I had myself put into solitary that night by accident, do you?
What do you mean?
Ah, sit on it.
What do you know about that? Come on, you bastard. Tell me, what do you know about that?
What's going on?
Just having a friendly little chat, Mrs. Barry.
All right. Come on, Burke, lock up time. Where's Delaney?
Showers.
Right. No more friendly chats while I'm gone.
Oh, there you are, Delaney. Come on, you're late.
Can you two shut up? I'm trying to get some bloody sleep.
You're scared of the dark, little. Can't you hear that music?
Bobby, you all right?
I'll be fine.
She's gonna die!
Shut up, will you?
You'll have the bloody screws down on us.
I'll be all right. Honest.
If Bobby's going to have a hard time, we'll stick with her all night if we have to.
What if she dies? Bobby, we've got to call someone.
Shut up, I said. So what do you think her chances of being in the morning in front of the brawl would have found out she was on dope?
You should have thought of that before.
I'll be okay. I'm just really cold. Rabbit, I'm cold.
We've got to make sure she doesn't hurt herself.
Come on, out you come.
Morning.
Morning, honey child.
Off to the showers. Go on, Hoppy.
Yes, sir.
Not you, Mitchell. I want a word.
I've got to get ready, Mr. C.
How could you be so bloody stupid? Don't you want to get out?
Of course I want to get out.
Don't take me for an idiot, Bobby.
One look at some of you this morning is enough to tell me that drugs are circulating. Now look at you. What have you taken?
Do you know what your chance would be at this morning's hearing if I reported this?
Not much.
None. You're so close. A whole new life ahead of you. Why jeopardize it? Who'd you get it from? You are letting everybody down, Bobby. Drugs are just a downhill run, and you know it.
I'm sorry. Thought I was going to cark it last night. I won't touch them again, honest.
I'm going to let you off. Don't you let me down again, okay? Now go and have your shower and clear your head before that hearing.
Thanks, Mr. C. I won't forget this, I promise.
Good morning.
Oh, g'day, Auntie Joan. Sorry about the mess, but I'm a bit out of practice.
Yes, I can see that.
Made you a cup of butter.
Yes, thank you.
It's going to be beauty living here again. Just what I always wanted. There's just one thing we've got
to do. Hang on a minute. Now, you know that's not possible.
But I want her. Can't you do something?
Look, you know, I would if I could, but they've made up their minds. It's certainly not easy to get the court to go back on its decision.
Well, I hate them. Stinking pigs, I hate them.
Hello. Time for coffee?
Oh, I'd love one.
How are you feeling?
I'm fine. Apart from a slight hangover.
Here.
This might help. Thanks. If I'd known you were going to ring last night, I would have got in earlier. It saved us both a headache.
I just wanted to make sure you were all right. Glad you had Chris for company.
Yes, me too. God, I'm glad that's over.
Oh, I wish you'd taken the day off, Meg. You need the rest.
No, I like to keep busy. At least the trial stopped me from worrying about the operation.
I'm sure it'll be all right. They're operating tomorrow?
Yes, yes, they are. Well, here's to the future.
I'll drink to that. On, chin up.
I haven't even got any mates in this dumb place.
It's hard when you go to a new school, but you'll soon make friends.
Honey Joe, I just want to be with you.
Hey, Shane, you want to play footy?
Yeah, come on, we're playing with Paul and the Harvey kids.
Looks like you're on the team, eh?
Yeah. Be there in a minute. Gonna be here after school?
No, I can't, mate. I've got to go to work. And you've got to go back to the tailors, understand?
Come on, Shane!
Come on. Cut it out, Honey
Jane. Oh, yeah. Okay. See ya.
Yeah.
Well, you better take a good look around the place, love. You might not be back here again.
Pigs might fly.
Oh, get back under your rock, Kelly.
Oh, forget her. She's just jealous. Here, Bobs, you got to cut the cards for luck, eh?
Oh, shit's probably stacked.
Ace of hearts, good luck.
Oh, Rabbit's right. You probably stacked the deck or something.
Me stack a deck, wouldn't I?
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Bobby. It's time to go.
All right. We'll be right in there with you, kid. Here, hold it for luck, eh?
Everything's closed.
Thanks. See you, kid. She's shaking in her shoes.
Yeah, let's hope it works for her this time, huh?
It screws on to us.
No way.
Oh, didn't you hear Mitchell? Crookshank's not stupid. I know someone's pushing and start a cell search.
What? If they don't know what they're looking for, they'll never find it, will they?
Here, take a seat, Miss Ferguson. Would you like a cup of coffee?
Oh, no, thanks, all the same.
It was nice to meet you at last.
Yes. We've been meaning to call you several times over the past weeks.
Only we really didn't think it was fair to involve you.
Well, I'm here now.
I'm glad. Shane talks about you all the time.
Let me set you right on something, Miss Ferguson. We want Shane. We've always wanted a son.
Very glad to hear that.
I'm sorry I was a bit short on the phone, but well, you know how it is. Marnie and I are Shane's parents now, and I thought you might have tried to interfere with what we're doing.
Oh, just what is that?
To raise Shane as though he's our real son. To give him all the opportunities we can afford so he can make something of his life.
It's very commendable. It's how it should be.
But unfortunately, he's proving to be quite a handful.
Oh?
Almost impossible at times.
In what way?
Well, he doesn't get on with other children. And his moods can change so quickly.
Yeah. When he's pulled into line, he stacks on the most incredible tantrums.
Oh, with due respect, Mr. Taylor, I've just left Shane at the school, and he was the same lovable child I've always known.
Yes, well, I can see where you may be a bit confused. Look, do us a favour, will you? Come to dinner tonight and see for yourself. Maybe you can help us after all.
Yeah, I'll do that.
What are you doing here?
Waiting for a good sort to come along.
Oh, shut up, Frank. I'm not in the mood. What are you doing in the cell block? Ferguson cops you here, you'll be on a charge.
Oh, not this time. Reynolds has got me doing odd jobs, so if you need an odd job...
Oh, rack off.
Keep this up and I'll take back the offer.
Stupid bugger.
You bastard.
You thieving bastard, you give him back.
What are you on about?
The dope, you bloody took it.
Why the hell would I want to do that? We're partners, aren't we?
Oh, now where's my gear?
Search me. You never know what you come up with.
You rat bastard!
What do you reckon's holding them up?
Well, I think they're having morning tea. An officer took a tray, you know.
Nice lady, wasn't she? Are you all right, Bobby?
Just a bit strung out, you know. Didn't get much sleep last night.
That makes three of us. Edie and I talked most of the night.
Couldn't stop him. He went from redecorating your room to our bigger wedding we could afford for
you. Stan, I haven't even moved in yet. You're planning on getting rid of me?
Just facing facts. I know some nice young bloke will steal you away from us someday. Anyway, I was keeping Edie company. She was cooking until past midnight for your welcome home party.
Thanks, Edie. Just hope you haven't wasted your time.
You're not getting cold feet on us, are you?
Well, you know what parole boards are like. You can have everything going for you one minute and then the next minute they knock you back.
Well, not today. You've been a good girl. You've got a good job to go to. Besides, it's me who's on trial today.
You better leave your pipe and whiskey flask out here with me, then.
We're ready for you, Edie.
Oh, yes.
You'll be right, love.
Well, of course I will, Stan. Stop fussing.
God, are you all right?
Oh, yeah. I feel like I've been hit by a sledgehammer.
Yeah, well, maybe you should have warded it down more.
Eh?
Oh, come on. Half this block's spaced out of its head. I'm not a fool, Kelly. Oh. I think you better hand it over right now.
I haven't taken nothing. You must have your wires crossed.
Well, you expect me to believe that? I just have to look at you.
Yeah, well, that's how I look when I get a whack in the jaw.
Oh, so that's the story, is it? All right. Who did it?
Nobody did it. I slipped on a wet patch and went over to you.
I don't believe you, Kelly.
Well, that's your problem.
Look, I know there's stuff floating around here somewhere, and I've got a fair idea where it's coming from.
Yeah?
Use your brains, Kelly. Don't be taken in by those fancy clothes.
No, we don't lag.
It is Patterson, isn't it?
I'll tell you something, though. Jaw feels great. You must be a faith healer or something.
Bitch, Lexie. If the screws had copped her, she would have lost her parole for sure.
If they did, just lucky it was the Yorkshire put. I told you, Lexie.
Anyone would think I pushed him down a damn throat, for God's sake. Look, it was a goodbye present and Bobbie was wrapped.
Yeah. Well, it's lucky for you that it wasn't a goodbye present for the Dobbs.
Yeah. Look, get off my back, will you? I gave and she took, and I didn't notice her counting to 10 before she did either.
You're just lucky Myra wasn't here.
What's she got to
Myra
do with it?
Myra is down on drugs and for very good reasons.
She already bashed Bobbie up once for having it.
Well, stop her! I take what I bloody want, and I'll share if I feel like it.
That'd be hard to say without two legs.
Oh, look out, Wog.
Hey, watch it.
It's all right, Judy.
No, it's not all right.
Oh, go suck an egg, Bryant. Here, it's all yours.
What are you so mad about anyway, Lexie? They have got a point, you know.
Get nodded.
Shoot a thumb to one, Jude. Bobbie had a really bad...
Will you shut up, Marlene, and just get some work done?
God, everybody's acting like swords today.
I've got a bloody good reason. Burke's taking me stash. Everything.
Rotten bastard, yeah.
And to top it off, with Crookshank under the rackets, there's bound to be a soul search. So we got to get it off Frank before the screws do.
Yeah, right. Listen, do you need Frances to help? She'll do it cheap.
Nah, I got a much better idea.
To add to this, the prisoner has been involved in 3 escapes and 1 attempted
escape. Oh, hang on a minute.
You wish to address the board?
Jeez, Mrs. R, they're making me sound like a big-time crim. I've been trying, honest I have.
Yes, we can see that. You tried to get to Sydney on one occasion.
I don't think she can be held responsible for being abducted, Miss Burns.
Yeah, the other time was just an accident, because Min and me got lost.
You are absent from the attendance of the officers on duty. You are not seen again for 24 hours. Now, you don't call that escaping.
No. Well, the officers were out of it. They didn't know we were going to come back. Just wanted one day to see what it'd be like to be free, that's all.
Irresponsibility coupled with violent tendencies, typical recidivistic behaviour patterns, and certainly
me, but
not...
I think you're missing a very important point. Bobby's tried very hard to prove herself, and that's not easy when most of her companions are hardened criminals.
Thanks, Mrs. R, but I reckon you're wasting your time.
Not at all, Bobby. Mr. Colby, it's been my experience to find that records are often misleading when read out of context.
Well, I don't believe they were read out of context.
If we gave a few more an opportunity to be free of this environment, we'd have a lot less overcrowding in our prison system. Don't you think so? All right, Bobby, we've had our say, now it's your turn. Tell us about this job of yours. Mr. McDonald seems to think you'll make a pretty good electrician. Is that what you'd like to be when you leave here?
I reckon it's ace.
Apprentices are very poorly paid. How do we know you won't go back to your shoplifting habits?
Because I've got a lot of people backing me, that's how, and there's no way I'm going to let them down. Sorry.
That's all right, just sit down.
Hi, gorgeous.
What are you doing in there?
Collecting details. God, you're a suspicious type, aren't you?
Every reason to be, Patterson. Never had time for pushes.
Then don't get anyone pregnant.
Well, I suppose you have a smart crack ready if Mitchell blows her parole.
Here we go again. You know, I'm getting bloody sick and tired of this.
And so am I. And believe me, if I catch you selling any more drugs, you'll be in more trouble
I'm not selling drugs.
My source is
well,
a good one.
Well, your source is way up the creek, mate. Bloody hell. Look, I can rake in a fortune with my cards. Why on earth would I risk selling dope?
If you're trying to pull the wool over my eyes, don't. Because you can be damn sure I'll get to the bottom of it. Okay? Now get going.
Hey, cards aren't the only thing I'm good at, you know?
Oh?
Glad to prove it. Anytime you feel like it.
You try that one on, and I'll slap a charge on you so fast you won't know it's happened. Now get going.
It's not my lucky day, is it?
So when do you think Bobbie will get out? I mean, if everything goes okay.
Any time between now and 2000?
What? Yeah, and the way the department works, I'm afraid she's right.
But that's crazy.
Mm. Yes, that's the word I would have used too.
At least she has hope.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, come on, don't chuck your dummy in the dirt.
Oh, Bobbie. God, speak English for heaven's sake.
Oh, what I meant was, don't chuck a wobbly because you'd be out of here in no time flat.
Which roughly translated means, you're going to get out of here, bail or not, right? So don't get worried.
Yeah.
I hope you are right, Judy.
Sure. You'll be gone and Bobbie will be gone, and then I'll have no one left to talk to.
Oh, thanks, heaps.
Oh, don't worry too much, Warren. From what I hear, Mitchell's going to be around for a long time.
Why, what's
what
happened?
Do you mean?
Let the chatter and get on with your work.
Oh, poor Bobbie.
Hey, hang on.
I've got a name, Kelly.
Yeah, right. Somebody's nicked my stash.
Miss Ferguson?
Yeah.
That is bad luck.
Bad luck for you if you don't help me find it, lady.
Are you threatening me, Kelly?
Oh, you could say that. Remember a word in the right ear about Murphy. Kind of tempting when you look at it from
us. Righto, Kelly, you've made your point yet again. Now, what am I looking for?
Art paper and crayons.
Really? Who's the artist?
Try Burksell. Miss Ferguson.
I tell you, there's definitely something on the move, and I'm sure it's drugs. I've seen some of the women this morning moving around like zombies.
Well, I was going to mention it to Meg, but I wasn't sure. Perhaps it's time we did a cell search.
Oh, it's ridiculous to have a full-scale search unless there's a damn good reason. I've got better things to do with my time.
And you don't think drugs are a good enough reason?
Come on, a few bleary-eyed women is not conclusive in my book.
Well, I think you better renew your book. Those women were more than just bleary-eyed.
Listen, I have seen more drug users than you have had.
I don't think you've seen the women that they're referring to.
Yes, it was before you came on duty.
They were definitely looking very bleary-eyed when we let them out.
See? Why have you waited so long to tell someone?
Hang on, will you?
No, I think there's been too much hanging on. Now, two officers have reason to believe that there are drugs in the prison. You're the deputy governor. Don't you think you should hurry up and do something about it?
There will be a search. We had just decided on that.
I'll take isolation. I was about to go up there anyway.
Good place for her. Think we could talk her into staying there permanently.
So, you see, I've known young Bobbie for quite a long time. Oh, I know she's had her ups and downs, but so does any kid of that age. The only difference for her is that she's had no family support to fall back on. That's what Edie and Mrs. Dobson and I want to give her. We think she's a good kid with a lot going for her. Mrs. Reynolds, do they know about the job she's got?
Yes, Dad.
Well, she really loves that job. And I'm sure she wouldn't do anything to harm her chances of getting her apprenticeship.
Mr. McDonald also told me that he'd be happy to give her a permanent position when she does get it.
Is that right? Well, there you go, then. Looks like she's home and host.
They did. They went through bloody everything. They even went through all Bobby's stuff and she wasn't there. I don't reckon that's very fair.
Not at all.
You don't reckon she's blown a release, do you, Jude?
I don't know, Rabbit. Let's just hope it's the freak having a stir.
Is this how they get their kicks or what?
Yeah, one of their ways.
The other way's making us clean up after you.
Spent a long time in your cell, Patterson. And tell me you've been holding out on us.
Go stick it, Kelly.
You don't look too worried, Lou. You know what they're looking for.
You don't think I'd be so stupid as to stash it in my cell, do you?
Mr. Crookshank, I need a hand here.
Coming.
What's the matter? What are you doing with that?
We're checking everything, Greenway.
What's the problem?
I can't get this lid off.
Well, look, let me, please.
Look in everything.
Yeah, even your toothpaste.
Shh. Looks like Burke did you a favour, eh?
Yeah, but don't worry. I'll be paying him back too.
Have I made myself clear on these points?
Yes. Yes, I understand.
Then bring the prisoner in, Mrs. Reynolds.
Should I leave?
No, that's all right, Mrs. Dobson. Just stand to the side, please.
We're ready for you now, Bobbie.
Was it all right for me to come too?
Yes, of course, Dan.
Stand before the board, Mitchell. Right. Case number 4732, Roberta Alice Mitchell. It is the board's decision that you be released under license in the care of Mrs.
Oh, we did it! Oh, damn, we did it!
Set out under Section 3 of the license.
Shh.
Oh,
you would better let the man finish.
I have finished. Could we clear the room?
Thank you, Mr. Colby. Wonderful, just right, wonderful face.
Very much. Yes.
It's lunchtime. How much longer are you going to keep us hanging around here anyway?
As long as it takes, Burke. Any more remarks, you'll be on a charge.
What else are you looking for?
She hasn't taken long enough anyway.
Probably planning something just to get at us.
Yeah, I hope that's not just a cover in case she does find something, Burke.
Of course it's bloody not. I don't trust her. Before Murphy was poisoned, that one beats him for dead.
Surprise me. Thought you had more brains than that.
Looks like you're all clean. Better tidy up the mess, we'll be late for lunch.
Sorry we wasted your time, love.
You wouldn't want to miss out on lunch as well.
That's what I reckon anyway.
Oh, stop bellyaching, will you?
I am not bellyaching. You wouldn't know what it was like to be concerned about a friend.
I thought you were concerned about your lunch being cold.
Oh, well, that too. That just topped it off, didn't it? And probably didn't even get any bloody lunch. She's probably up there in the pound right now, crying her eyes out.
Come on, but why would she be in the pound?
I don't know. Just get off my back.
She's very worried for her friend.
Oh, stupid cow. Doesn't she realize no news is good news?
Not around here, it's not. And your little antics didn't help either, did they?
Oh, talk about stuck bloody records.
Bacata, your solicitor's here.
Hey, yes, Mrs. Betty.
You keep your foot crossed, Judy.
Yeah, I'll keep my foot crossed.
Well, that's about all we can do till we get her in the workshop.
Hey, this is looking great, you know?
Yeah, sure is. Hey, where'd you get your casters?
Oh, let's just say I found them.
Uh-huh.
Boy, everyone seems down the dumps today.
Bloody good reason, too.
I guess so. Hey, you want a game of cards or something?
No, thanks.
Just some matches. I wouldn't take your money. Okay. I guess you just want to be by yourself, huh?
Oh, look, I'm sorry, Matt. I didn't mean to take it out on you. Tell me more about the UFOs. Did you really see one?
I think so. Got a good geek at it through the scope. It's a good one, too.
Yeah, you must be really serious about this stuff. Did you spend much on the scope?
You broke me.
Hey, everyone, grab it. I'm getting out.
If you'd help me pack, and then I'll come back and say goodbye properly.
You're on.
Me too, Bob. Let's go. I've only got 10 minutes, and we'll hurry back.
In a few days. It is so soon. But it is good, Emil. Then you will be free. That cannot be. It's true, Mr. Humphreys. I have killed a man. They will say you stay here like the other women.
I don't think that.
No. It is better now. We have this, You tell her, Mr. Humphrey. What is it?
Things do look brighter, Mrs. Picarda. A witness has come forward to
say... So what happened, dear Emil? It is not your fault. He will stand in court and... Sorry. This witness will help?
I don't want you to get your hopes too high, but he signed a statement saying that the other driver was definitely in the wrong. I'm pretty hopeful that we'll get a suspended sentence.
You see? Suspended is good? It is very good. You will come home with me that day. It is hard to believe in this place, but...
Be assured, Mrs. Picarda, this witness has saved your bacon, as the saying goes. Now, I'll be seeing you again before you take the stand, so I'll leave you with your husband.
Yes, thank you. It is good news. Emil, I must tell you, I have found a new house where we could be without the family. It is much better now. And you will see, I have made many plans to give us much happiness. I think it is better if we have just one thing first. I leave here. Then we think of the rest, Ahmed.
You want me to ditch Fred?
Nah, stick him in. Memento from Wentworth. Anyway, Pete, it works real good at fixing things like that.
Hey, what about your stuff on the wall?
You and Rabbit can have it.
Oh, great, I bagged this one.
Get up, that's a pick of the bunk. Oh, come on, here we go again. You two are meant to be best mates and you're carrying on like you hate each other's guts.
No way, I hate all of them.
Being serious, Lexie.
Yeah, I know.
I'm not trying to lay it on you or nothing, but don't reckon I would have made it in here without me mates. Mates all you got once they shut that gate behind you. It's bloody stupid to be picking on each other all the time. Listen to me, will you? But blame your apprenticeship, I can always go to preaching or something like that.
No, you're right, Bobs. I just like getting a rise out of the old rabbit, that's all. Bites better than a bed bug on rations.
Oh, bull, you just like...
rotten bugger. We'll call a truce, eh? Going away prison for old Mother Mitchell.
Yeah. I miss you, Bob.
Oh, that's very touching. Looks like you're getting out in time, Mitchell. Didn't know you and Warren were quite that close.
Yeah, you'd know.
What was that?
She said we were just saying goodbye.
Well, say it and get to the rec room. Come on, Mitchell.
Now?
Yes, the Dobsons are waiting, or have you changed your mind about leaving?
Miss Ferguson, I promised I'd go back and say goodbye to everyone.
Get out now.
Here.
Hi, Bob.
Knock him dead, kiddo.
Move it, Mitchell!
Tell the others what happened, eh?
And our own house to live in. Oh, Ahmed is so very happy. I hope it happens good in the trial.
Oh, I don't think you have anything to worry about, not after what your solicitor said.
You think?
Right on, Yamil. Roll on freedom, eh?
Hey, come on, don't look so worried. It's gonna
She's gone.
Bobby?
The bloody freak wouldn't even let her come back for 5 minutes.
Bastards, they do that at Woodridge, too.
You're arrogant.
It stinks.
So do I.
The windows.
No, it's
we can see us open the windows.
Frosted.
Come on, everyone. We'll yell our bloody heads off. Give her a whammo.
How does it feel?
Great, I guess. Except I wish I'd have been able to say goodbye properly.
Oh, never mind. I'm sure they'll understand.
And you'll be able to write, Bobby.
Just a minute, what's that?
I think the dead can hear us.
Well, I'm gonna make sure.
Come on. What are you gonna do?
Oh,
stand back!
You
kidding me! Come on, everyone! Give me all you got! See you, buddy!
Son, what's happening?
It's your idea, they're just saying goodbye to their mate.
Oh, how I? Stupid buggers!
That's some farewell, all right.
Tell them I heard, will you, Mrs. M?
Yes, I'll tell them.
Well, ladies, come on. Let's go home.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun.